This is gorgeous. This is yummy. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we have a new brand to my channel, a brand that I've been looking at Sephora for a while, and their newest release really caught my eye. So we will be trying Danessa Myrick's Yummy Skin Serum Foundation together today and wear testing it to see how it performs on my combo oily skin. How's it gonna do with my textures? We don't know yet, but it was intriguing. Aesthetics aside, it's a medium coverage, radiant finish, filled with a bunch of hydrating ingredients and oil. So I picked up shade 7N, which is described as a light to medium with neutral tones. This foundation comes in 26 shades. I don't have an arm swatch photo of the range with the updated shades. I think I have the original 12 and then now there's 26. I am so excited to give it a shot. And their graphics are so cute. You can see the key ingredients and the undertones available in the line. So there's P for pink and peach, N for neutral olive, G for golden olive, and W for peach red. So that is why I went with neutral, because I feel like neutral having a little bit of olive tones would be perfect for me, since I am more of that beigey yellow undertone, medium skin tone, light medium sometimes. When it first came out of the tube, I was a little concerned, because I was like, I mean, there's still a chance, right? So let's just, you know, get nice and close. Clip the undone hair back. It's giving me egghead right now. Not really feeling that, but get it out of our way. Something really cool about this foundation is that it is a refillable foundation. So the cartridge actually comes apart. It's pretty self-explanatory. You just twist off the bottom, and this is actually just a cap. And you can see the shade stays in the middle, and then you twist off the top, and there is a squeeze tube applicator. So you can purchase the whole foundation for $34 or just the cartridge for $24, you know, as a refill. But sustainability, Fenty did it with their Icon lipstick. Now we got refillable foundations. We've always had like a few refillable moisturizers here and there. That's kind of cool. We're having a decent brow day today. Eyelids are prepped with a little primer powder, but otherwise the face is pretty darn bare. This is what the color looks like right out of the tube. The tube has a lot of control because it is squishy, so you can really go drop by drop. I did look at the application methods and they described it by drops. So one drop was gonna give us lighter coverage. I'm doing my, you know, palette technique. So if we really wanna test out the drops, we'll do that on the other side of the face. But it says brush, sponge, fingers, any of the above are totally fine. We're just increasing in coverage with each drop, which makes sense. It just means, you know, more product, obviously. So right off the jump, we don't see the tones yet, right? I have a feeling it's gonna set a little darker, and I really hope so, because even though my face is paler than the rest of my body, I don't want it to be right now. It has the freshest skin and lacks the most attention in the sun, so it's pretty normal. I actually brought it kind of close to my eyelids today. That's kind of cool. We'll see how it hangs out there. I really like the finish because this is the finish I'd want in a concealer too. If you've tried other products from Danessa Myrick's, please let me know. If you're unfamiliar with the brand, she is a self-taught makeup artist. I just read up on her story and it's like beautiful. She's responsible for the amazing Benefit Brow collection that we got a few years ago. You know, the pomade, the pencils, the gels, the setting, all that stuff. She was at Benefit at the time. And claps to this queen. Black owned beauty brand, female owned, all that good. Like, read into it, it's a beautiful story. I've been eyeing her contour products for a bit, and I can see right now that the product went in really hydrated, really glowy, but it is settling down. Do you guys see that? I hope you do. Like, it's still hydrated, but it is like sinking into just like a really pretty, my skin is so healthy, it's glass skin finish. Ooh, okay. Let's make sure this line isn't too harsh right there. But it's settling. And we're gonna give her time. So this is actually a Sephora Collection Milk Makeup Brush, but you can use anything you want. This is a flat top angled situation. I usually pick this up or like a round top, all the same. Really gives like Sigma Beauty circa 2013 vibes, but smaller. Kinda want it a little bit right here under the brow, but I have a little powder there already, so I'm just trying to be really gentle without destroying my eyebrow. So I have a fresh acne scar on this side from a clogged pore that was just really, really stubborn, but I also have texture in this area. I'm not adding any more product. Just kind of tapping it with the brush. Ooh, that glow is serious. I do feel like it's adjusting a little bit, but it's not giving me my tones. And this is what it looks like on the palette right now. We didn't use all of the product that we poured out. I think it's gonna be wearable. it's looking better and better. Oh, my cupping marks are showing. Hello, cupping. Yeah, this is gonna be wearable, but this is not gonna ever work for me in the summertime. We're gonna have to drift probably. I could see myself closer to 9N in the line or even 10G at my tannest, but this is definitely winter, spring me. But wow, look at that before. Discolored, uneven, after. This is gorgeous. This is yummy. My nose, not too happy though. You can see a little breakup a little bit. So let's do the dropper effect. Okay, here we are. One drop with a sponge. Ooh, bring that around town. To be expected, the sponge pushes it in really fast. Really sinks in, maybe absorbs any of the extra glow from the different oils in the formulation. It has our hyaluronic acid, it has some marula oil, something similar to that, and jojoba oil, turmeric oil. There's some oils I've never tried. There's a little squalane in it. I usually say squalane, but I'm trying to practice saying squalane. Of course, we don't know the percentages of anything, but I can definitely see that there's some oils here. As far as this side to this side, the sponge is absolutely settling in. So if this is a little too glowy for you, go with this method. But it's so pretty. It actually matches my face perfectly, but I usually match my neck. Truth be told, for my foundation twinsies and anyone who checks out my shade comparisons down below, I will probably be exchanging it for a different shade. So it's kind of tough. Like if I squeeze it too much, it separates a little bit from the bottom. Whatever's left on the brush can go down here too. But I'm it does go a really long way. We didn't need too much, but you can absolutely build up to medium, like a really good medium, if you, you know, use a little bit more product. It layers beautifully. I'm gonna layer just over some of these sunspots right here with whatever was left on our palette. You really get into the sides of the nose beautifully. I just don't think it likes my nose, and I wasn't experiencing any sort of dryness there, which is really surprising to me that it is showing up in this way. So maybe hold off on the exchange. There is a beautiful primer that they released with this. It's sold out everywhere. I tried to get a sample some places. Even the testers are gone, guys. It comes in two different shades. It's kind of like glowy. It's giving MAC strobe cream underneath foundation vibes. If you've tried that and you really love it, let me know. It feels like if I tried that, it might be a little overly glowy for my skin type, because this is already like, you know, this might be maximum glow for me. But it's pretty. I'm gonna use Armani's Luminous Silk Concealer in 5.75 today. I really hope this isn't darker than the rest of our face. The shades in this product are very interesting, but I felt like this was an appropriate finish for what we got. I don't actually want to go over like anything around here, because it's already kind of upset on my texture. It doesn't seem to like my texture, which is surprising. But I'm just gonna press it in otherwise up here. When I'm this hydrated, I don't know if I want to go cream contour or if I want to go powder. I feel like sometimes the powder will stick funny, and sometimes I feel like the cream's just gonna slide around. I'm gonna go with the Makeup by Mara Soft Sculpt and see how that plays together, because I think it's that nice like formulation that might not give us a super hard time. I really wish I could like yank this off and get the brush versus the brush being there sometimes, but it's okay. I'm gonna use my Patrick Ta brush, which is a really dense situation. Boop, and then take it to the cheekbone. And I'm just placing the excess product around before blending, so we don't have too much on our brush. I've been seeing people post footage from the Bieber concert that's been, you know, postponed for ages and ages. I've actually had tickets since the lovely year of 2020, and that's coming up soon. So excited for that. And by soon, I mean like 2 months from now, but I actually haven't been to a concert in ages. I think this might be the third concert of my entire life. So it'd be nice to kind of like, you know, get a little cute, maybe do a little get ready with me, something like that. Mario and Patrick just coming through, supporting the cause. We love this, because we need this warmth right now. We really, really do. It's playing really well off of these oils, which is nice to see that it's not breaking up. This is shade medium, if you are wondering. I've done a separate review when this Soft Sculpt collection came out. Like, we tried the blush and such like that. We won't be using that today. Doesn't it seem kind of funny how like we even out the skin tone and then we kind of place back the tones that we just erased, but in more of an even way? Makes sense, but also seems like a lot of work if you were more of like a outside the makeup world looking in type of person. Okay, I don't want it to be too harsh right there. There we go. Give me that pointy chin.
without the double, make it a single.
Then I'm also gonna do a little something around the nose. You know, it's not my favorite part to do because we're still working on it. If anything, it's making our nose look a little better. Not sure why, but it is. Like, you don't see as much of the like weird settling there, but I'm sure if it wants to be seen, it'll be seen by the end of the day. Per usual, the only thing sharp really is my upper nose bridge, but it is what it is. I'm taking a little bit of a Pat McGrath powder, light medium two, just kind of setting the side. And this is also getting our oily areas because we get very oily in this part of the nose. So we're gonna need a little protection there, a little set there, and just patting this onto my under eyes. I am usually more of a sponge gal for this area. Sometimes it gets a little messy and the brush is more precise. The rest of our face actually feels really good. I do think we need just a light bit of something something because you can see it's kind of settling into my fine lines already. Looks a little masky. We have some Kosas Cloud Set in Cushiony. Just gonna pat that on gently. This is so nice and thin in its own way. It's like a transparent yellow, so it doesn't mess with things too much. I'm actually gonna lightly bring that around here. The chin's looking a little dewier than we wanted, but just that, just a light kiss of powder. Upper lip, places with lots of movement. Considering setting my contour, this is the KVD Shade and Light Duo. I feel like I tried this before and I didn't like it on me. I don't know. I don't want to do too much. I don't want to lose the contour either. I do have the coordinating powder to it, so I don't know why I'm over here just, oh God, oh God, it's, oh God, no, you're forbidden, no. Two strikes, you're done. Gosh, don't you hate it when that happens? I am sorry, Mario. I am so sorry. You deserved to not be put second. You should have been. First thing I grabbed to set cream product. So that's the starting point for our face. I think we could do a little highlight. Do we want a little highlight? Maybe. Interested to see what we're gonna look like by the end of the day. It always kind of makes me sad. I'm sure I'm not the only one who's like, oh, like the finish is so pretty. I wish I could rock it just like that. But that's not the skin type we're built with, you know? We're not. Putting a little Fenty. It's already on my desk. A little Fenty Mean Money. I'm probably gonna throw on a little bit of an eye. What I'm gonna do, I don't know, but I do have this brand new, what are you called? Moisture Glow Plumping Lip Serum. It's like a lip balm from Mario. This is in Apricot Glow, and I am, oh my God. It always looks so good on Instagram. I had to buy it. My dry lip said now. It's a little thick, but I'm not mad at it. I just need it to be a little even. So when you first apply it, it doesn't really feel like anything. And then it gets super creamy in the container. And then you can feel like a minty tingle start. And I'm making sure that minty tingle gets all the way to my jaw areas, cause hello, that's their appropriate place in the class. It feels good though. The thick feeling kind of starts wearing away. Now it's just like a moisturized, slippery feel. So here's a little before the lips. We'll see with reapplication and trying to keep this on the majority of the day if it's gonna give us a little bit more plump. I'm gonna finish up my eye makeup, do a little something, give you guys close-up cam footage, starting point pictures, and then see you guys at the end of my day. It is 8:30 and we are back after 10 hours of where I haven't really looked at my face all day. So let's look at it together. Let me give you guys the pictures and close-up cam footage. Overall, it photographed beautifully. I think it's a very flattering, very smoothing formulation. I like what I'm seeing just off first impressions. I think the sides of my face look very smooth. I did wear a mask for a short period of time where there was some transfer. It seemed like mainly my bronzer was transferring because it was the high points of my cheeks and like my jaw. It wasn't a lot, but there was some marks here and there. Of course, there's no transfer claims to talk about. Really, there aren't many claims for wear at all. So we're just going straight down to performance, like what we see and how we feel. I do think I look hydrated. I look youthful. Dare I say a little yummy. I know. Cringe, Sam. Very cringe. Forehead. Good decision to set it. I feel like it looks pretty smooth. There is still some fine lineage, as you can see from the movement. I actually put on a little eye today, so I feel kind of pretty glam. It's one of those rare days where I actually glue my lashes on top of my lash line again. So who is she right now? My nose contour, definitely still there. Definitely still a little strange because you know we're not professionals here. I'm still trying, still improving, but the end is not happy. And I don't think the foundation liked the end of my nose at all from the get-go. Oddly enough, it doesn't feel oily. oily, but it does feel like it might have rubbed off with the mask. Like, I'm feeling straight skin. I just don't think I like that area from the get-go, so that's something to take into account. The rest of the face, though, feels amazing. The setting it, absolutely set it. It doesn't look cakey. It wears down very smooth. It looks like skin, except for my textured areas right here, but it looks like skin. It really does. Like, oh, skin and blush. Skin and blush vibes. I like that. Shade is still something that we definitely had to bronze up. Without the bronzer giving us dimension in the face, I think it would have looked quite pale. I was in a hoodie most of the day, so all you could really see was my neck. I still stand by my statement that this would be the lightest I would recommend for those who usually wear the same shade as me, but it could have looked worse. The vibe, obviously, really similar to what I like. I love the packaging. I love the sustainability. The price is pretty reasonable. The range looks pretty good, especially with the new edition shades, like all 26 together, like pretty impressed. But I don't think this is a plus. I almost don't think this is a minus. I'm teetering between A minus and B plus right now because I do see my forehead not looking as smooth. And then we had the nose area to count in for. The chin actually looks a little cakey. So overall, it doesn't like texture. Areas that you're smoother, it's cool with. It doesn't seem to mind pores because I do have large pores right here. But we did have a little assistance from the concealer to a certain point. But mainly the pores look totally fine. So I won't say that it's not okay for oily skin. I think you're just gonna have to watch out for those situations where I didn't know there was any sort of texture on my nose at all. Like, that's not something I visibly can see until I put on this formulation. So texture gals, texture twins, think about this before. Maybe sample it. My forehead's really, really drawing my attention. But I am very impressed with the fact that I'm not feeling greasy and I'm not feeling heavy. It's very light on the face. Light and smooth. That's the vibe. Light and smooth. I would give this a B plus because the forehead and the nose and the chin. But it's really pretty on the other areas. Really, really pretty. Absolutely hydrating. Very hydrating, we should say. But set still beautifully. And still, you know, has a better appearance than a lot of foundation. So, B plus. It shall be. The fact that it's a serum foundation kind of surprises me. Because, yeah, I get they're using serum kind of loosely. But it just feels like a liquid foundation. It really does. Like a liquid gel, almost, in a way. It's not a different texture for serum. Serum, I think, like dropper bottle. And to me, that's still like a liquid at the end of the day. But marketing, you know, marketing. Such a vibe. So I think we got to say bye now because my lash, done. Do you see the difference a lash makes? Like, for real. These are the new plant fiber hemp derived lashes from Velour in style Cloud 9. Really fluffy. Coupon code down below. That's how long of a day it's been. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I hope it was informative, helpful, or just entertaining in some way or another to see my first impressions. If you're interested in watching any of my other recent uploads, I will put them on the screen right now. I will be back very soon with some other new releases, so if you would like to stay tuned for those, you can hit that subscribe button right here. It's free 99, and I'd be honored if you wanted to join our little family we have here. Thank you guys again, and I'll see you guys in a later video.